Anyone can build a landing page, but turning it into a real working web app, you definitely need to be a software developer to do that, right? Think again. Last time, we vibe coded our way to a pretty landing page. Now it's time to take it to the next level. Today, we'll turn that static page into a real working app with user login, a protected dashboard, and working backend using Next.js and Supabase without writing a single line of code ourselves. Vibe coding with Cursor. Let's go. Hey, Alex here from GritAI Studio. Welcome back to Vibe Coding with Cursor, where we build real projects with no prior coding skills required, just maximum creativity. In this episode, we'll transform a simple landing page into a real Next.js application with GitHub version control, Supabase login, and a protected user dashboard. The basic ingredients to any real application. And of course, we're doing it all with AI-assisted coding in Cursor. We're vibe coding our way towards a full running coach app. But whether you're building that or something entirely on your own, these are the steps that take you from idea to an actual product. First, let's set up Git. Before we make any changes, we want version control in place to track our progress and avoid breaking things. This is good practice and also makes our lives a lot easier if we want to jump back to a previous version or if we want to automate deployment of our application to something like Vercel, which we'll do in a future video. You can easily set up a free GitHub account, and when you use Cursor for the first time, you can log in with this GitHub account to make everything smooth when developing your application. In Cursor, I'm opening the project folder, initializing a Git repo, and creating a new GitHub repository to push to. I'll choose the private option for now. And there we have it, our very first commit. Now let's upgrade this project to Next.js. We'll use version 15 with AppRouter and Tailwind for styling. So Next.js is a very popular web application framework on top of React for building fast, scalable web applications. We'll also use something called ChadCN to bring in beautiful, accessible UI components with minimal effort. We'll add a few rules to Cursor to make everything a lot easier for us. First, we'll add rules for Supabase, which we'll add later. Now let's add rules for Next.js to ensure we follow the latest and greatest standards. Remember, context is king, and the more we guide Cursor here, we'll save ourselves a lot of hassle down the line. So now that we have our rules set up, let's run this prompt. Since we already have some files here, we want to be specific about how we want our new application to be created. Let's prompt something like this. Convert this project into a Next.js app using the AppRouter and Tailwind. We'll also use ShadCN where applicable. Create a complete application in a new subfolder called RunningMind. Then apply the layout we currently have in our existing index.html to our new app page TSX. And then we'll just tag our rule file. Now Cursor starts creating the files. I have autorun turned on, so it will do almost everything except for deleting files, which I want to confirm manually. Once cursor completes the conversion, we'll see a new structure with app folders, route-based layouts, and React components. Now, we don't really need to understand everything that's going on here just yet, but in brief, Next.js handles routing, server-side rendering, and scalability. Perfect for what we're building. Our main page is here, and we can see that front-end components used by our page are found here. It has also created a separate email form component for us. In the public folder, we'll find our images and assets used by our page. We can see that it's also created a gitignore file for us, which we'll come back to later. The package.json file is where all dependencies are defined, such as Next.js, React, and Tailwind. Cursor has done all of this for us based on our initial prompt and the scaffolding that it used to create this project. Since we asked Cursor to create our new app inside a folder called Running Mine, we want to do a few quick changes here. The reason why I did this was to avoid any conflicts with the file already in our project. That has now been cleaned up by Cursor, so we'll just manually move all the files up to the root of our project. So that was a little workaround there, which would not be a problem when you start a blank project. Just drag it up and then delete the Running Mine folder. So now we're ready to test it. Let's run npm install, and then we can run npm run dev. Or you can just ask Cursor to run the application for you. We should now see our landing page running inside a modern Next.js app. Look at that. So when this is running, we can make changes to our page, and the changes will be updated automatically in our browser as long as our dev server is running, which is really cool. A quick heads up. We just launched a private community called Vibecode Studio on School for people who want to learn how to build cool stuff with AI with no prior coding skills required. We've got practical courses built for creators who want to ship real things, Q&A sessions, and a super supportive community of AI builders. Check out the link below. We'd love to see you inside. Now's probably a good time to commit our changes. Before we commit anything, let's talk about gitignore. So this file tells Git which files not to include. Cursor has already generated this file for us. We'll just make sure that we exclude things like node modules, the build output, and especially any sensitive files like our env files. Remember, never commit API keys or passwords to Git. These should always live in your environment variables, locally on your computer. That's why we use this file called env.local. So now we can look through our changes and add our files and then generate a commit message. Since we haven't really changed anything ourselves, we just accept all the changes here and commit it to our repository. With the app running, let's bring it to life with authentication. We'll use Supabase for signup, login, and user session management. Eventually, we'll also use it as our database. Start by creating a new project at supabase.com and grab your project URL and public anon key. We'll add these to our project later. Now, to get this part right, we'll make use of the Supabase rules we added earlier. This makes it easy and avoids a lot of hassle. This in essence guides Cursor to the correct approach of using Supabase. We can then use a prompt like this. Set up Supabase client in this Next.js app. Implement login with magic link. Create a login route and redirect authenticated users to dashboard. Follow the instructions in our rules file. Cursor will wire up the Supabase client, add auth logic, and create basic login and redirect flows for us. This gives us our first gated page, the dashboard page. We'll expand this dashboard in future episodes to include training plans, run logs, and coaching features. So now let's add the project URL and public anon key from Supabase to a .env.local file in your project like this. And now we're ready to try it out. Enter your email, click the magic link, and get redirected to your new dashboard. For now, we've just used a super simple approach with magic link login. We can add more users and change this flow to username and password, proper signup, etc. later. For now, this is an easy way for us to get started. We can also change the template for the magic link email if we want to. One thing to keep in mind is that the Supabase free plan has a built-in email server that will take care of sending emails to your user and users in your team. But once we take our app public, we need to add a proper email provider. We'll cover that in a future video. Okay, so if we log out again, we can see that this page is no longer possible to access without being logged in. Every time we try, it just redirects us to the login page. We do, however, want the landing page to be accessible to everyone. So let's ask Cursor to help us change that. Great. Now, all pages require login, but we want the root page to be available to everyone. But routes such as /dashboard should require login. Can you help me update this logic and add a login button on the main page? And that's it. We have an actual web application with login and our first protected route established. Supabase gives us authentication out of the box, but we probably want to differentiate between access levels like regular users and administrators. We will cover this in the next video and build logic to restrict access to certain routes or features based on roles. For now, just keep this in mind. We're setting the stage for role-based access without overcomplicating things in this episode. Before we sign off for today, let's add some project documentation and commit our changes. I'm dropping in our initial scoping document so that we can track what we're building. We'll evolve this into a full PRD document later on. Let's update our README file based on current functionality and add a section about where we're heading based on our initial scoping document. And now all we have to do is review our changes, stage them, and generate a commit message. hit commit, and that's it for this session. We've taken a static page and turned it into a real web application with login, routing, and backend logic. We set up source control with GitHub, converted the project to a modern web app with Next.js, and added Supabase authentication. All without writing any code by hand, just using plain English and a bit of vibe coding magic. In the next episode, we'll start building the actual features of our running coach, personalized training plans, progress tracking, and more. If you enjoyed this, hit like, subscribe, and drop a comment about what you're building. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.